Again, guys, this is just a quick, this is just an experiment where we're going to try and work on this. I think later we'll have to be able to do this job, so we might have to just this, out of interest, just this bit of a, okay, so we're going to run this job. This is going to be black and white, but this battery's not going to last, so it's always good when you're working with photocopiers as an art medium. Although we can be very spontaneous, sometimes we have to be, we have to think it through, because we get better results when we think. When we're trying to force it at the machine, we often find we create rubbish. Not always, but that's been my experience over the many years. So basically, we're just going to set this up quickly. This could just be, you know, for entertainment, just to see, watch me have a little experiment. But I really think we should master these copies maybe on this device or some other device that's less grainy. As black and white machines tend to be a little bit too on the grainy side, so we're just going to try and probably get this muffed up anyway, because talking and copying don't go down too well. So I'm going to try and do text photo xerographic. But I know you guys like to see big machines running. It's really cool. You know, nothing like a big banger. I don't know whether to play with the colour balance or whether just to keep it looking fairly authentic. But, you know, it's nice to get the contour results with this. But this battery isn't going to hold out. Now, I've got to do a lot of work, but we may not even play with that, because we want to keep the copy looking fairly grunty. So we'll just leave it at that and we'll just run the job. Yeah, so I'm going to get the sharpness, I'm going to set it down, soften it up a bit, get rid of some of that grain. Although grain is good, we don't want too much grain. We'll see how it goes. A bit disorganised here, but you've got to take it as a bit of an entertainment as well, because, you know, photocopying was often viewed in the 90s as a form of performance, you know, dance performance, as well as making images. You know, you've got to think of the good days, good old days. The thing is to note also is that, you know, you guys may be more technically tilted. We have other people who are more artistically tilted, as well as myself. But we all have a place, you know. But we can all learn from each other, you know. You technicals can teach me how to be more technical, and we artists can teach you how to be more artistic, if that's what you desire. You know, you don't have to do it. But this is the negative image that's come out of the copier. It's quite nice. So we've got a bit of a mashup happening here, but we have to work on this later, I think. Because it's got to go back. Then we've got to take it back to the DocuColor. And then we've got to take it back here. Oh, we've got to do transparency. So I don't think we're going to finish this job today, but this is just to get, just to experiment, because this is a production copier. It's more accurate. That machine is better taken. So you can see the image quality, it's quite a pleasant looking image quality. In fact, I just want to make sure maybe if I can crack down these settings, if they're still in the device, maybe go. But I don't think they're optimal settings, but they're pretty good. So we've basically got basically still that lovely authentic graininess without it being too grainy. Because we end up copying off that glossboard machine, we're going to lose too much quality. And this being production copy has much quality, and the paper quality is good in there too. So, but I've got a lot of uploading to do. And I've also got to change my. I've also got some big data coming onto me. I've got 200 gigs waiting for me. I've got to set up my router to work on my dad's ADSL connection. Also, have to dump all this information on my phone onto my 1 terabyte hard drive. I've got to get it done at a video conversion shop in my suburb, Mona Vale. So a lot of work to do, not to mention a heap of tubing up to do. Now hopefully this ADSL connection will be a lot faster. So my data's gone now. I've done my 15 gigs in the month, so we've got another source of data coming to us. We've just got to set it up. So that's it. I think we just call that one a wrap for today. But just